Hi everyone, Christina here. Welcome to another Make a Card Monday video. Today I'm going to be doing something a little bit different, and the inspiration behind this is that giveaway I did about a week ago where I asked you guys what type of cards you wanted to see, and a lot of you answered that you wanted to see more masculine cards. So I thought this would be kind of fun to try to create some sort of galaxy, kind of with stars and nebulas and things like that. And I'm using some paints to do that. So I'm using some Tim Holtz Distress paints, mostly just because these are the paints that I have on hand. And also I'm going to be spraying it and adding a little bit of water. And I think these distress paints react with water differently than a regular acrylic paint would. So if you have acrylic paints at home and you want to try this out, go ahead and try it. I don't know how it will work, but that's how you discover new things, is by experimenting. So go ahead and just try it out with some paints that you have at home if you'd like. So I'm using basically five different colors. I've got Evergreen Bough, which is the green, Mustard Seed, which is yellow, Salty Ocean is the blue, I've got Picket Fence, which is white, and then I've got Black Soot, which is black, and I just dabbed that on there, and now I've sprayed it with some water, and I'm going to smush some watercolor paper right on top, and I'm going to really smear it around. I'm just trying to get a layer of color. I'm going to be adding more and more colors on top here. So I think that looks kind of cool, not really galaxy-like, but still kind of cool. So I dried that, and then without cleaning up my craft mat, I went ahead and added a whole bunch more of this black soot, because I really want for the galaxy to be mainly black with just little bits of color, and then I'm going to be adding some like splotches and dots and things like that. So I've added a lot of this black paint. I'm going to spray that so it's wet and will move around just a tiny bit when I press my watercolor paper on. So I'm going to press this on, and it's going to be really, really dark when I pull it off. And you're going to wonder, like, why did you even do the first layer? But you want that layer of color. So I like how like that there a little bit of the blue came through, and a little bit of the green, a little bit of the yellow. So now I'm going to work on adding some like splotches. Almost as if you took, like, you know how you can take like a toothbrush with paint and kind of flick it and get like paint splatters. I'm going to get a little bit of a look like that, but I'm not going to make it as messy as doing all that flicking and paint splattering. There's nothing more annoying to me than having a bunch of paint all over my craft desk that I can't get up because I was working on something. So I just put a bunch of those colors down. I'm going to spritz it. Then I'm going to take a dry paper towel and kind of dab it over those areas just to pick up a little bit of that paint, and it also distributes it a little bit more. So I'll just press that down once, and when I lift it off, you'll see that I have little tiny dots of color, and that's exactly what I want. So I'm going to go ahead and dry that one more time. Then I'm going to add a whole bunch of white, because white is going to create all the stars and the little bits of color and brightness in my galaxy. So just a bunch of white. And I want to make sure that I actually don't end up with those circular ends of the paint dauber. So I'm going to really pick that up with the paper towel and kind of distribute it around a little bit. And then smush my watercolor piece down on it once more. And this is when it really starts to look like a galaxy. To me, anyway. I think it looks really, really cool. It starts to look like a galaxy with the white splotches. And the white does dry back just a tiny bit. So I'm going to just pick up a few more little dabs of it here and there. And I'm going to put a big blob of white paint here in the middle because I want to get a really good spot where there's lots of stars and little dots of color. You could also, if you don't have white paint or you don't want to get as random as this, you could just use a white gel pen and just draw in some dots. This is so much faster and it's kind of fun, and I kind of like the aspect of not really knowing what's going to happen or what it's going to do. I kind of like that. So there we go. And I think that looks super, super cool. So I'm going to dab this down one more time and then hit it with my heat tool and then move on with the rest of the card. So I'm just going to draw that and I'll move on. And for the base of the card, I used some Fog cardstock from Simus Stamp, and I cut off the front of the card. I cut off about an inch, maybe an inch off the front. And then I have this piece of gray cardstock that I've stamped in with black ink using a stamp, background stamp from Hero Arts. This is this really cool background stamp, and it's like a reverse stamp, so it's stamped black, but it looks like it was like gray on black paper. It's really kind of cool. So you notice that the cardstock is gray, And then when I turn it over, it looks like it's more black than gray. I just think it's a really cool background stamp, especially if you do kind of like this monochromatic look like this. So I'm just adhering that on the inside of the card so that when the card is closed, you get a little peek of that pattern. I'm going to be using this stamp set from Technique Tuesday. This is the I Like You stamp set. I'm going to be using a greeting and I'm going to be cutting it apart. And I know you're going to think I'm crazy. You're probably going to hear the stamp screaming in your mind. What? Screaming. No, it's fine. The stamp is fine. I can mount it back together if I want. So if you have stamps like this that it's just too long for what you're doing, you don't want to mess with the masking, go ahead and just cut your stamp. It's not going to harm it. Just be really careful when you cut it and make sure you don't cut off any letters. Make the cut in the middle of a word. That would not be smart. So don't do that. But you can cut it apart to make like two lines of a sentiment like I did here. So I'm stamping a little star from that same stamp set. It looks like a little drawn star. And then I'm going to be bringing in the Lots of Stars stamp set from Simon Says Stamp, just because I want to get some differing sizes of stars. So I'm going to go ahead and stamp a bunch more of these stars. And I'm stamping everything in Versamark ink, which is a clear, sticky ink. And because you can't really tell where you've stamped after you've done it, after I stamp each thing, I'm coating it with some white embossing powder. And then once the embossing powder is on, just heat set it, and then I'm ready to move on. I wanted to add a little strip of color, and I wanted it to sort of match the green tones that are in the galaxy. So I took Evergreen Bough Distress ink, which is, you know, like the distress paint color, and I sponged that onto some cardstock, and then I cut a really itty bitty strip, and I'm adhering it to the edge of that galaxy paper. You'll notice that I also rounded those outer edges of the galaxy. I used a corner chomper, a Weir Memory Keeper corner chomper, and I used the half inch rounder. And I'm going to be adhering this onto the front panel of the card, and I'm just going to put it on here. I realized as I was editing this video that it's not entirely centered. It's a little bit more near the bottom, but that's okay, not a huge deal. If I really wanted to, I could cut off a little bit off the top. So I took my corner rounder and I rounded those two edges that are like the short edges of the card front. So I thought that looks just kind of cool. And then I took a Wink of Stella clear glitter brush pen and I went over that green area. And I also went over a few little areas on the galaxy. Not a whole lot because I realized it didn't show up too much after I started doing it. So I thought, well, why am I doing this? It's not even showing. So I only did a few little pieces. Then I took some glossy accents and went over that little stripe because I wanted it to really stand out. And just giving it a little bit of a shine, a little bit of glossiness, gives it a different texture. And so it stands up away from the rest of the card. So I'm going to give you a close-up of what the card looks like. I just think it's a really fun technique, and you could add pinks or oranges for this galaxy, but I wanted to keep it more masculine, so I just used greens and blues and a little yellow. But that's the card for today. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you guys on Wednesday for a new Color Wednesday. Thanks! So I have some more masculine cards for you to check out. One of them is more for a little boy, but I think they're all great gender neutral or more masculine cards for you to check out. So click on any of those videos on screen, or if you're on a mobile tablet or a phone, the links are down in the video description so you can go and see those videos as well. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button, and if you aren't a subscriber, please hit that subscribe button, and you can visit me at my blog at kaywarnerdesign.com. If you click on it right now, it will go directly to today's blog post. And once again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time.